It's an ordinary day. You're walking down a typical British street. The cars passing by look familiar, but something's changed. That sleek EV isn't a Tesla. That stylish SUV isn't a BMW. And that compact hatchback definitely isn't a VW. Welcome back to the Electric Oracle. I'm Des, and today we're getting into a transformation that's sending shockwaves through Britain's automotive landscape. This is a shift so significant that it's making traditional manufacturers sweat bullets, and with good reason. So, here's a number that's really going to blow your mind. In just 12 months, BYD, a brand that most Brits had never heard of, saw their sales explode by 658%. Not 65%, not 165%. We're talking 658%. But you know what? That is just the tip of the iceberg. Because while everyone's been focused on these explosive sales figures, something far more significant has been happening beneath the surface. You see, a fundamental shift that's about to take a sledgehammer to the entire UK automotive landscape. And just think about this. Last year, if you wanted an EV under £30,000, you had 9 options. And today, that number has more than trebled to 29 models. And the kicker? Almost all of that growth came from one place, China. But listen, this isn't merely about cars anymore. It's about something far bigger. So let's get real for a moment. The UK's cost of living crisis isn't just a headline. It's a fundamental reshaping of how we think about big purchases. And you know what? Nothing exemplifies this better than what's happening in our car market. Just take the BYD Dolphin. At £25,000, it's turning heads. But what if I told you that this same car sells for £13,000 in China? Nope, that is not a typo. That's the reality of what's possible. Now, you might think this is solely about price. And you know what? When I started digging into the data, I discovered something rather unique. Something that explains why this shift was not just predictable, it was inevitable. The thing is, while traditional manufacturers were busy protecting their profit margins, Chinese brands were busy doing something else completely. They were expanding from just 34 retail sites to 173 in a single year. And they were doubling their market share inquiries from 1.3% to 3.4%. And they were doing all of this while Britain became Europe's largest EV market. But here's where things turn interesting. There's a hidden factor that most industry experts aren't even talking about. Something that's about to accelerate this transformation even faster than anyone predicted. And when we look at the numbers, something remarkable emerges. You see, Chinese manufacturers aren't just undercutting the competition. They seem to be rewriting the rules of what's possible in the EV market. Just look at these figures. The average price gap between EVs and traditional cars has plummeted from 35 to 24%. Guys, that's a £3,500 straight back into buyers' pockets. But here's what most reviewers aren't telling you. The price advantage isn't just coming from lower labor costs. It's actually coming from something far more significant, vertical integration. You see, while European manufacturers are busy juggling hundreds of suppliers, companies like BYD are doing things differently. They're making everything. They're making things from batteries to semiconductors in-house, and I mean everything. And you know what? We're not just talking about a few pounds here and there. No, this is about fundamentally changing the economics of EV production. You see, what happens is when you control the entire supply chain, you can do things that would be impossible for traditional manufacturers. Now, the data shows a clear generational divide that nobody saw coming. So let me throw some numbers at you. 57% of 17 to 34 year olds are attracted to Chinese EVs. But when you look at the over 55, that number plummets to just 25%. Why, I hear you ask? The reason is because it's not just about price. It's about a fundamental shift in how different generations view brands, technology, and value. You see, younger buyers aren't just accepting Chinese brands, they're actively seeking them out. They're comparing specs, they're sharing reviews, and most importantly, they're not carrying the same prejudice as their parents. But you know what? There's something even more surprising in the data. Do you remember when I mentioned BYD's 658% growth, right? Well, that happened while only 31% of Britons even knew who they were. Just think about that for a second. They achieved this explosive growth while most people had never even heard of them. Now let's put things into perspective. MG, do you remember that MG? Has already reached 21st position in brand rankings. And they did this in a climate where traditional manufacturers were spending billions on marketing. But here's the thing. Chinese brands expanded from 34 to 173 retail sites in just 1 year. And do you know what? That's not gradual growth. That's not careful expansion. That's a full-scale market invasion. And the projections, they're even more eye-watering. You see, by 2030, Chinese brands are expected to capture 25% of the UK EV market. And that's 400,000 cars every single year. You know what? Something even more significant is happening here, though. Something that traditional manufacturers are either actively choosing not to see, or they don't want to admit it. Now, this is where we need to address the fly in the ointment. Do you remember that fundamental shift I mentioned earlier? It goes far beyond just car prices. You see, we're living in a time of unprecedented economic pressure. Inflation is eating away at our savings, rising taxes are squeezing disposable income, and traditional manufacturers, they're still trying to protect their profit margins like it's business as usual. See, let me put this into perspective. Manufacturer discounting totaled over 4.5 billion in 2024. That sounds impressive until you realize it wasn't anywhere near enough. Because while we're offering token discounts, something bigger is happening. You see, the number of zero emission models available in the UK market jumped 38% since 2023. And believe it or not, now we have 132 different models to choose from. But look, here's the crucial part, and this is what traditional manufacturers do not want to acknowledge. You see, the majority of that growth came from Chinese brands. And you know what? They are just getting started. You see, by mid-2025, EV sales are expected to reach 440,000 units. That's 24% market share. And remember those young buyers I mentioned? They're not just early adopters, they are actually trendsetters. You see, this isn't just about market share. It's about a fundamental realignment of the entire automotive industry. And it was completely predictable. Think about it. When you have a population under financial pressure, when traditional manufacturers keep pushing prices up, and when new players offer comparable quality at lower prices, what exactly do you think is going to happen? This isn't about brand loyalty anymore. It's not even about heritage. And it definitely isn't about patriotism. Those days are long gone. You know what's happening? It's all about survival. People, it doesn't matter who they are, will vote with their wallets. They always have, and you know what? They always will. From what I can see, the traditional manufacturers have three choices. Number one, they can adapt and compete on price, maybe. Number two, they can justify their premium with genuine innovation. Or number three, they can watch their market share evaporate. And you know what? Here's the reality check. Most of them aren't even ready for any of those options. They're still operating on outdated assumptions about brand loyalty and consumer behavior. The writing isn't just on the wall, it's being projected in neon lights across every dealership in Britain. And you know what? The transformation isn't just likely, it's inevitable. You see, what happens is when a population is squeezed by taxes, and when inflation erodes purchasing power, and when traditional manufacturers prioritize margins over accessibility, there is only one possible outcome. You see, the real question to me isn't whether Chinese EVs will transform the UK market, it's whether traditional manufacturers will wake up before it's too late. So question for you, do you want to stay ahead of the curve? Because every Thursday I send out a comprehensive analysis of the week's biggest developments in the electric vehicle space. From breaking technical innovations to market movements that matter, the Electric Oracle Weekly delivers the insights you need straight to your inbox. It's free, it's focused, and it's made for people who want to understand where the industry is really heading. You'll find the sign-up link in the description below. My name's Des from the Electric Oracle. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, keep charging forward.